Hello students, I hope all of you are doing very well. All of you are fine and healthy at your home out of corona. Okay, and today we are going to start from section 8.6.5, that is half-life in radioactivity. Okay, in today's class we have studied a lot of other factors like disintegration law, then emission rate, then we have studied about alpha particle decay, beta particle decay and gamma radiations we have studied. Okay, then the laws related to them we have seen, then whenever radiation happens what changes happen from parent atom or parent nucleus to daughter nucleus we have seen in the class. Today in this video, in this blending class, we will start from section 8.6.5, that is half-life. Okay, from new book of publication year 2021, this is in 9th unit and the section number is section 9.6.5. okay, so let us start about half-life. As the name itself suggests, half-life means the time taken by nature to decompose any material by half of its mass. Okay, before we start our today's video, I request to all of you that if you have any doubt related to any of my previous video or in this video also, you can ask the question in the comment section or in the classroom also. Okay, and also please subscribe my channel Pratik Singh Classes. This is all for the tutorial purpose, not for monetary reasons. Okay, I created the channel only to teach you, to guide you, not to earn money from that. Okay, this is a myth that I created the channel for money. Okay, if you are thinking like that, then you are stupid. You don't know the rules of YouTube. All right, coming to our question, half-life. It is difficult to calculate the time taken by a given sample of n atoms to decay. That means if suppose we have a sample of consisting of n number of atoms, then we cannot find out how much time will be taken by all the atoms to decompose, okay, or to disintegrate. However, we can calculate some other terms, like we can calculate the time taken by the given sample of atoms to reduce some fraction of initial amount. Means suppose the disintegration started at t is equal to 0, okay, or t is equal to t naught, then after some time t, how much disintegration has happened? We define the half-life, that is t half, as the time required for the number of atoms initially present to reduce to one half of the initial amount. Okay, that means either in number or either in mass, the total time taken by the atoms to decompose or to give out radiation and become half of its initial amount is called as half lifetime. The half life is the important characteristic of every radioactive sample. Okay, and let me say you one thing, that whatever element atom we see around us available on this earth, every atom is in general radioactive. The only thing is that some elements are highly radioactive and some are very less or negligibly radioactive. Okay, but whatever elements we have in nature, it may be either naturally or artificially radioactive. And also every element has an allotrope, isotopes, like that. Okay, some radioactive nuclei are known to have half-life as long as 10 to the power 14 years, and some nucleus have very short lifetime of just 10 to the power minus 14 seconds. That means there are some nucleus, there are some elements which are radioactive, will become half of its amount than initial in 10 to the power 14 years. Okay, this is so big number. Okay, this will even become more than the time of our earth, more than the life of our earth, okay, till now. And also there are some elements which has a half life of just 10 to the power minus 14 seconds. Okay, we can express half life in terms of decay constant, that is t is equal to t half, the number of undecayed nucleus, n is equal to n naught by 2. That means when time t is equal to half time, then the number of nuclei remain undecayed is equal to initial number of atoms divided by 2, or initial number of nuclei divided by 2, that is n naught by 2. By substituting this value in equation 8.35. okay, we get n naught by 2 is equal to n naught into e to the power minus lambda t half. Okay, or we can write 1 by 2 is equal to just put cancel n naught from LHS and n naught from RHS. We will get half is equal to e to the power minus lambda t half, or e to the power lambda t half is equal to 2. Now take logarithm both sides. Okay, in mathematics you might have studied the rules of log. Okay, if you are belonging from pure science, this hasn't come, but just memorize it. Okay, if we take log both sides, we will have t half is equal to log 2 by lambda. Okay, log 2 value is 0.6931, then t half is equal to 0.6931 by lambda. Okay, a note is given here. One should not think that shorter half-life material is safer than longer half-life material, because it will not last long. Okay, this is a myth that we say that any atom which has a shorter half-life will be better than the atom or the element or the material having higher life half-life term. The shorter half-life sample will have higher activity and it is more radioactive, which is more harmful. So keep in mind, lesser will be the value of t half, higher the element or higher the nucleus will be radioactive in nature. If the number of atoms present at t is equal to 0, means at initial time is n naught, then n naught by 2 atoms remain undecayed in first half life, then for second half cycle, the amount of or the number of nucleus remain undecayed will become n naught by 4. Likewise, in next t half time, the amount or the number of nucleus remain undecayed will become n naught by 8, and so on it will go. Okay, so there will be a sequence. Okay, in GP, geometrical progression, you have studied in mathematics, AP, GP, HP, like that. So here we will have a half-life formula in a GP term. Okay, so in general, after n half-lives, the number of nuclei remaining undecayed is given by n is equal to 1 by 2 to the power n into n naught, where n is the number of half-lives, okay, and n naught is the number of nucleus initially, okay, where n is the integer or non-integer. It may be integer or it may be non-integer also, since the activity of radioactive sample also obeys exponential decay law. We can also write an equation for an activity similar to the previous equation, that after n half-lives, the activity or decay rate of any radioactive sample is r is equal to 1 by 2 to the power n into r naught. Means, as the life will change, half-life will go on, what will be the activity or radioactivity of the element? It is given by r is equal to 1 by 2 to the power n into r naught, where r naught is the initial radioactivity when the number of atoms were n naught. Now there comes mean life or tau. Alright, the actual lifetime for each nucleus varies from 0 to infinity. It means that if suppose we have a sample of n atoms, then which atom will disintegrate first and which atom will disintegrate last, we can't say. Okay, so every atom or every nuclei will have equal chance that they will disintegrate at some certain time. Okay, therefore it is meaningful to define average life or mean lifetime that the nucleus survives before it decays. Okay, and it is noted by tau. Okay, this symbol tau, you have studied this in first volume also in classical physics. The mean lifetime of the nucleus is the ratio of sum or integration of lifetimes of all nuclei to the total number of nuclei present initially. Okay, the total number of nuclei decaying in the time interval from t to t plus del t, means in time del t gap, how many number of nuclei disintegrated? It is equal to r into del t, that is lambda n naught into e to the power minus lambda t into del t. It implies that initial the that until the time t, this r into del t number of nuclei lived. So the lifetime of this r into del t number of nuclei is equal to v t into r into del t. Okay, in the limit del t tends to zero, that means in infinitesimally a small time gap, the total lifetime of all the nuclei would be the integration of t r dt from time limit t is equal to 0 to t is equal to infinity. So here we can define mean lifetime is equal to integral the rate of disintegration divided by total number of nuclei remaining at the time when the disintegration started, that is integral t r dt from 0 to infinity by n naught. It will give integral t into lambda n naught e to the power minus lambda t dt from 0 to infinity by n naught. After a few integration, okay, this expression for mean lifetime will become tau is equal to 1 by lambda. Note that mean life and decay constant is inversely proportional to each other. Once again, mean life and decay constant are inversely proportional to each other. That means higher will be the decay constant, lesser will be the mean life, and so on. Using mean life, the half life can be rewritten as t half is equal to tau log 2, or t half is equal to 0.6931 tau. Okay, so this is the relationship between mean life and half life of any radioactive element. Okay, coming to next topic, let us see what is the next topic. Now this comes section 9.6.6. Okay, that is carbon dating. Carbon dating is a process to find out what is the life of any fossil, okay, when it was survived, or how much older any fossil is, or any element or any material is. All right, so let us start this topic, section 8.6.6 carbon dating from the old book, and section 9.6.6 that is from the new book, carbon dating. Okay, the interesting application of beta decay is radioactive dating or carbon dating. Okay, using this technique, the age of an ancient object can be calculated. Recently, one excavation has happened at Kiladi. Okay, there the Archaeological Survey of India have found some very old ancient civilization which is older than 2000 years. Okay, sometimes the archaeological people, they say that Kiladi excavation site is older than Indus Valley civilization, but it is of the matter what results they will get. It lies on the hands of future. Okay, all living organisms absorb carbon dioxide from air to synthesize organic molecules. Okay, as we are living organism, in our body we have everything made of carbon and its compound. Okay, the protein, the fat, the carbohydrate, whatever is in our body, it is one or the other form of carbon and its compound. Okay, so in this absorbed carbon dioxide, the major part is 6C12 and very small fraction, that is just of 1.3 into 10 to the power minus 12 part, is radioactive 6C12, whose half-life is 5730 years. Okay, means in our body we have carbon dioxide. Okay, some of those carbon dioxide contains carbon atom 6C14 and a large of them is 6C12. Okay, we know very well that 6C14 is radioactive and its half-life is 5730 years. That much used. Okay, carbon 14 in the atmosphere is always decaying, but at the same time cosmic rays from outer space are continuously bombarding the atoms in the atmosphere, which produces 6C14. So the continuous production and decay of 6C12 in the atmosphere keep the ratio of 6C14 to 6C12 always constant. That means in any living organism, the amount of 6C12 to 6C14 will always remain constant. Since our human body trees or any other living organism continuously absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, the ratio of 6C14 to 6C12 in the living organism is also nearly constant when they are alive. But when the organism dies, it stops absorbing carbon dioxide. Okay. Since 6C14 starts to decay, the ratio of 6C14 to 6C12 in a dead organism or specimen decreases over the years. Once again, as the living organism dies, okay, the amount of carbon dioxide being absorbed stops. Okay, and there the ratio between 6C14 and 6C12 changes because 6C14 is radioactive and it will start decaying. Suppose the ratio, or specimen decreases over the year. Suppose the ratio of 6C14 to 6C12 in the ancient tree pieces excavated is known, then the age of the tree piece can be calculated. Means to find out what is the ratio between carbon 14 and carbon 12 is found out, we can find out what is the age of that fossil. Okay, here you can see the Killari excavation site, how very ancient city was found, and this is the charcoal which is sent for carbon dating to US. Okay, carbon dating is a very costly process, and in our country we do not have that much sophisticated tools to do this precisely. So every time whenever archaeological survey people, they find out something, they send it to US or to find out what is the age of that fossil or of that object. Okay, so this is all about carbon dating. Okay, the next topic, let us see what is given. Okay, discovery of neutrons. It is not in your current syllabus. We have section 8.7, that is nuclear fission. In new book, it